Today I presented the improvement of heart failure with procalcitonin study at the European Society of Cardiology Heart Failure meeting. And procalcitonin is a biomarker of bacterial infection, so why should we use this in acute heart failure? We found in observational studies that once you use procalcitonin in acute heart failure and use antibiotics properly, patients benefit with respect to mortality. So as this has been studies being retrospective, we designed a prospective randomized controlled study with an open intervention where patients were randomized either to get a PCT-guided antibiotic therapy or a standard therapy where antibiotics are just indicated on clinical standards. We calculated to have 796 patients to be randomized in this study, and criterion for entry were not only the suspicion of acute heart failure, but also a certain level of natural peptides. We ensured with this strategy that patients are at high risk because the natriuretic peptides had a certain high level, for example, BNP above 350. We randomized 762 patients, and then the study had to be stopped due to futility prematurely. And surprisingly, the result was that both arms, the study, the procalcitonin treated arm and also the standard arm, had the same mortality at 90 days. Cause for that was that the mortality in general was very low in this study. We had calculated 18% mortality rate for the standard arm, but the mortality in general was only 9% in the whole study, so it was 50% lower than the estimated mortality in the control arm. So we think that with this low mortality, there was not much space to get approval of the therapy by a PCT additional biomarker measurement. With respect to clinical implications, we think that the concept to use procalcitonin in acute heart failure is biologically plausible, and it's also guideline recommended, and we still see that this is a valid concept. But with our study, we were not able to prospectively see in a randomized study that this concept will work in every patient. So we feel that in the future we will need to focus with other studies on patients with more infectious burden, so having higher PCT levels, more infection, and that the problem of this study was not that the marker does not work, but that we had the wrong patients selected, so kind of selection bias. And finally, we did a retrospective analysis now in our study on the marker of PCT, and we saw the markers working. So if you have a high PCT, you have worse outcome in the entire population, but the intervention does not work due to the low mortality. Thank you. We'll be right back.